Data Portal Genomic Data Commons, GDC Video Guides, Charlotte Sackett, GDC User Services Senior Scientific Support Analyst, Center for Translational Data Science, University of Chicago. Introduction to the GDC Data Portal. This video will provide an overview of the GDC Data Portal, which is a web-based platform that allows users to search, analyze, and download data from cancer genomics studies. Data Portal Overview. The GDC Data Portal is a repository and computational platform that allows cancer researchers to work with harmonized clinical and genomic data. Clinical biospecimen and molecular data, for example, sequence data, are submitted to the GDC from cancer research centers using standard data types as defined in the GDC Data Dictionary. The GDC employs bioinformatics pipelines that realign the molecular DNA and RNA sequence data against a common reference genome build and generate derived data. The processed and harmonized data is then made available on the data portal, where users can perform analyses through GDC analysis tools and download files of interest. The GDC data portal is accessible at https://portal.gdc.cancer.gov. Data portal layout. The GDC data portal is composed of a header, main toolbar, query expression bar, and application area. Header. The top left section of the header provides access to the four main features: Analysis Center, the central hub for accessing all the tools in the GDC data portal. Projects. Allows exploration of all the projects within the GDC data portal. Cohort Builder. The Cohort Builder tool consists of a variety of clinical and biospecimen filters for building custom cohorts for analysis. Repository. Allows exploration of files associated with a cohort. The top right section of the header provides links to the video guides, the GDC support team for sending feedback, and provides features such as browsing annotations, managing sets, downloading files from the cart, and login to obtain access to controlled data. Login requires an ERA Commons username and authorization to the study from the database of genotypes and phenotypes, otherwise known as dbGaP. Main toolbar. The main toolbar is used for managing and creating custom cohorts and is always visible in the Analysis Center and Tools. Users can utilize the main toolbar to view information and perform a number of actions on their cohorts, such as creating and saving a cohort. The main toolbar also provides access to cohort summary charts. Query Expression Bar. The Query Expressions section displays information about the filters applied to the current cohort and allows convenient operations to be performed on those filters. Application Area. The application area is the main window that reflects the selected application, including core tools such as Cohort Builder, Projects, and Repository, as well as analysis tools available in the Analysis Center. Data Portal Workflow. The GDC Data Portal is a cohort-centric cancer research platform. Users can create custom cohorts based on specific projects, primary sites, disease types, or any combination of clinical, biospecimen, and molecular features. Custom cohorts can then be used with various tools in the Analysis Center to perform further analysis. Files from custom cohorts can also be downloaded for further analysis with other research tools. The most common workflow for users involves creating a custom cohort, after which users can run specific analyses on their cohort and/or download files of interest for their cohort. The first step, building a cohort, can be performed using the Cohort Builder. From the Data Portal homepage, let's click on Cohort Builder in the header. We're going to build a cohort of 50-plus-year-old TCGA BRCA cases, so the first step is to locate the project filter, click on the magnifying glass in the card, and search for BRCA. Now we can click the checkbox next to TCGA BRCA. To add the 50-plus filter, let's go to the Demographic filter category and locate the Age at Diagnosis filter. We can type 50 into the box to the right of From greater than or equal to, then click the blue Apply button below. This results in a cohort of 794 cases, which we can see in the cohort toolbar. Note that the number of cases may change as data is updated. To save our cohort, we'll click on the square floppy disk icon to the right of the cohort name, which is currently unsaved_cohort, then choose Save from the drop-down menu. We'll name our cohort TCGA BRCA 50+, and click the blue Save button in the bottom right corner of the pop-up. Now we can analyze our cohort using the data portal. To do this, let's click on Analysis Center on the far left in the portal header. The Analysis Center is the central hub containing all tools. The core tools, Projects, Cohort Builder, and Repository, are displayed above the analysis tools, which perform various clinical and genomic analyses. Each analysis tool card displays a case count, which corresponds to the number of cases within the active cohort that have the corresponding data used by the tool. Notice how the clinical data analysis tool would use all 794 cases in our cohort, but the cohort level math tool would use only 698. We can also view the description of each analysis tool by clicking the down arrow next to each tool's name. We'll expand the description for the mutation frequency tool. We can launch this tool by clicking the blue play button in the upper right corner of the card. After building a cohort, we can also download cohort data. We'll click on the repository button in the portal header to go to the repository, which is where data files for each case in the active cohort can be browsed and downloaded. The repository is where we can apply file-level filters. For example, let's expand the Experimental Strategy card and select WGS. This will filter our results to only whole genome sequencing data. Let's also add a filter for copy number variation data under the Data Category filter. We can then add individual files to the cart by selecting the cart icon to the left of each file, or we can click Add All Files to Cart if we want all whole genome sequencing copy number variation data files. The final core tool is the Projects application, which provides an overview of all harmonized data available in the GDC organized by project. Besides offering filtering options and a table view of all projects at the GDC, the Projects application also allows users to create a cohort based on a specific project. For example, clicking on the TCGA GBM project will launch the project summary page where we can view high-level data about the project. In the upper left corner of the pop-up window is a button, Save New Cohort, which we can select to create a cohort of TCGA GBM cases. We'll name this cohort TCGA GBM and click the blue Save button. Data portal resources. There are many resources that can assist in navigating and utilizing the GDC data portal. Our documentation site offers a data portal user's guide with detailed information on each aspect of the portal. In addition, we have tutorial videos which provide walkthroughs as well as use cases for each portal feature. These video guides can be found embedded on our documentation site or on YouTube. The GDC's main website also contains other resources for end users, including upcoming webinars, webinar recordings, and an FAQ section. Finally, any questions pertaining to the data portal can be directed to the GDC User Services team at support@nci-gdc.datacommons.io.